Alright, let's see. What are we gonna talk about? I was debating between either talking about Misty or talking about Jesus. Now, I know talking about Jesus in the middle of a Pokemon game, it's not exactly consistent, but and I said I shouldn't talk about him during Pokemon battles because then I can't concentrate. And I can't think straight enough. Oh man, you lived through it. There we go. Okay, got him. So I guess we'll talk about Misty this time since I'm sort of in the Pokemon spirit. I'll fight you with Dragonite. Remember how I was saying before how I really hated Misty? I stand by that, and I didn't have an excuse before, really. I just kept saying because she was this and that and the other thing. Let's start at the very beginning. Remember how Ash's Pikachu was injured? And after Misty, I'm going to talk about Ash. Ash does not get off of this. Ash's Pikachu is injured, so. And I think that's because Pikachu didn't get in the Pokeball, Pikachu was out. And I think Misty actually, what, saw Pikachu or something? I think she actually harassed Ash about not taking care of Pikachu or something like that. But what happened was, in order to get Pikachu to a Pokemon Center so that he would live and not die, Ash stole Misty's bike. Now, stealing is stealing, no matter how you look at it. But, you know, if I had, you know, a valued family member, friend, who was about to die because, just because they'd gotten beaten up on, you know, sustained massive injuries. Yeah, I think I'd do pretty much anything and then just ask the person's forgiveness later. And by the way, Misty never forgave Ash for stealing her bike. I mean, yeah, he did more than that. He did kind of wreck it, but it wasn't his fault. It really wasn't. Pikachu, he used his supercharged Thunder Blast to beat up all those Spearow, and he electrocuted the bicycle. Well, that was out of Ash's hands. What was Ash gonna do? Was he just gonna get pecked to death by them? Because these aren't regular birds or anything. These are Pokemon. They actually have devastating powers. Pokemon are capable of hacking down trees, at least Scyther is, you know, just with their claws. Can you imagine how much damage these Spearows could have done to him? So Pikachu saves Ash, and Ash saves Pikachu, and then Misty gets angry at them for it. And she will not stop bitching. Like, consider, let's see, what happens? I know Team Rocket makes their first appearance later, and they take over the Pokemon Center. And, let's see, Ash and Misty did team up, and what did Misty, let's see, Ash was failing. And Misty was like, well, I can do so much better than that. So she sends out a Goldeen on the Pokemon Center floor. What was she thinking? Goldeen, Misty? Seriously? Not next to a body of water? She's like got this unfounded sense of superiority. I mean, yeah, Ash sucks, but I might as well be saying, well, I'm smarter than George Bush. That's not saying a whole lot, guys. So Misty, Ash and Misty somehow managed to be, let's see, what'd they do? Oh, Pikachu rallied up all those other little Pikachus in the Pokemon Center, and they electrocuted Team Rocket. So after that, what happened? Oh yeah, Misty continued to follow Ash, and she continued to give him a hard time in the forest. Oh, this guy, he's like, I heard rumors of a child prodigy. I always used to think that he was referring to me, but he wasn't. You know, sometimes this game brings you back down to earth, and it's like, no, you're not the biggest thing ever. Live with it. But anyway, so Misty follows Ash into that forest place just because he busted her bike, and it was probably something else. There was probably the, really cheesy little love thing at work. No, I'm not denying that's a possibility, and I do know for a fact, as everyone knows, that later on, Misty and Ash do indeed start to develop feelings for one another. But Misty harasses Ash for the longest time, And then Ash is like, "Then why are you still following me?" I'm not following you. This happens to be the quickest route to where I'm going. Well, if that was true, Misty, then why now? Why not just do it? Why not go back to your little fishing spot, fish up whatever you needed to fish up, and then go back? Why do you have to follow Ash? Well, whatever. So Misty follows Ash and she gives him a hard time for being a crappy Pokemon trainer, and Ash sort of deserves it because, he captures a Caterpie and he's like, "I am the greatest." And so she chews him out about not knowing how to capture a Pokemon properly. Oh, so it was you who beat. Okay, so in this game, I'm sorry to change the subject, but in this game, apparently they do recognize you as the child prodigy. I don't think they did in the last game. Anyway, so Misty. She yells at Ash, never gives him a second's break in the forest, and it's not until like he gets his Pokemon to. And she hurts Caterpie's feelings for many times just because she's got a phobia of bugs. Now, I used to be homophobic. I'm not anymore because I actually had a gay roommate and I really got to know him as a person. And I also have a gay friend named Kirk. His name we nicknamed him Captain Kirk. So I mean, I used to have a phobia of them. I got over it. But and I never hurt their feelings even while I had a phobia. I never said I don't know. Maybe I might have looked at them a little weird on the first within the first couple of minutes of knowing them, but after that, I was civil with them. Misty, on the other hand, I believe at one point she had a phobia of Caterpie. So what she did was she clobbered Caterpie with her little anime mallet. Where did she even get that from? An anime mallet? I don't know where these girls in anime get their mallets from, but they have them, obviously. So anyway, oh, you know what? If I go up this ladder here, I wonder if this resets that boulder. Let's find out. Oh, by the way, dudes, this is where Zapdos used. I mean, not Zapdos, Moltres used to be. Where are these little shiny things? I have no idea. Okay, all these Golbats in this cave, and I can't escape. Come on. Leave me alone. Okay. Wow, I've been ranting for a while. Look at that. Only got 2 minutes left. All right. Well, anyway, so Misty proceeds to both verbally and physically abuse Caterpie, and Caterpie's just trying to be her friend. Yeah, Caterpie does kind of push himself on her, but only because it likes her, and it's a Pokemon. It doesn't know any better. It's smart enough to know feelings, sort of, but it says, "I'm trying to be your friend. I've done nothing wrong to you." Boy, maybe I am prejudiced against Misty. I mean, the Caterpie did, I guess, sort of push itself on her a little bit, but whenever somebody says something bad about you, wouldn't you want to try to vindicate yourself? Say, "No, I'm not a freak. I can be civil just like everybody else." Misty doesn't even give Caterpie a chance. And then when Caterpie eventually beats up Team Rocket, which was really unrealistic, by the way, should not have happened. Darn it, this trap reset. I gotta do this again. Sorry, dudes. Misty just never gave Caterpie a chance until Caterpie proved itself. But why does it have to prove itself for her to be civil to it? Yeah, she doesn't like carrots. She doesn't like. By the way, I like carrots. Screw you, Misty. I like carrots. But anyway, because she doesn't like bugs, that's all the more reason she needs to be uncivil. Not cool, Misty. I'll rant more later on, but for now, I'm gonna try to concentrate and just get past this one boulder thing. And then afterwards, when we get to the next segment and I know I'm in the clear, I'll rant some more about Misty because I can think up more episodes later on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Get the boulder in, get the boulder in. Go up, down, 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 and over, and boom. All right, and we'll be back shortly, so catch you guys later. Thanks for watching, as always.